Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have several prayer requests, so I want to ask all of my prayer warriors out there, and there are many of you, to please get your pencil and paper and get ready to jot down our prayer requests. We have several. There are a lot of people here among our YouTube family members who are in desperate need of prayer, and I know that our prayers are answered every day. I get emails and comments telling me how our prayers were answered and how much you appreciate that we think of you and pray for you. So while we're waiting for everybody to get your pen and paper, I want to ask you to please consider subscribing to my channel. You will be welcomed with open arms, and you will be loved and accepted here. And we include you in everything that we do and talk about. So today I'm going to be reading out of my book from my subscriber. It's called The Heart of Jesus, and this is written in as if Jesus were talking to us, and I really love this book. It has already blessed me so much. So today the verse is going to be from Deuteronomy chapter 31 verse 6. And it says, "So be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid and do not panic before them. For the Lord your God will personally go ahead of you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you." And I know many of y'all who have followed Christ in your life since you were a young child. I was saved and baptized when I was 12 years old. When I was attending Hickory Grove Baptist Church there in South Mississippi, outside of Lumberton, and I was baptized there in Parker Creek. And I'll try to remember to attach the link to the video where I take you to Parker Creek and showed you where I was baptized. So let's go ahead and get started with our prayer request, and then we will read this. Actually, it's on page 7 of the book, The Heart of Jesus, and it is titled My Love. So we will read this, but let's get the prayer request mentioned first. Our fellow YouTube creator, Frugal Mama in the Woods, her name is Beth, and she had asked us a week or two ago to pray for her mother, who had contracted COVID-19, and unfortunately, I have to I'll let you know that Beth did inform me that her mother died. And of course, Beth is grieving and struggling right now. And I've been praying for you, sweetheart. And I just want to ask all of you to please remember Beth and her family in our prayers today for the loss of her precious mother to the COVID virus. And Wanda Landers, she is facing a double mastectomy. She has to make the difficult decision of whether or not to have the double mastectomy or to go through all of the treatment that is involved on just getting the tumors treated. And also her husband is suffering with dementia. So Wanda, we know that you have a lot on your plate right now, but we're going to pray for you and ask God to lift some of your burdens and to heal you. And my good friend Linda, she told me that she has a cyst on her ovary, and it's a huge cyst. I think she said it's called a complex cyst. So right now she's undergoing tests and blood tests and MRIs and CAT scans to try to determine if the tumor is cancer. And of course we want to pray that this is benign and that there is no cancer whatsoever in this tumor. And Linda is possibly facing surgery to have the tumor removed, and the doctor may have to remove her ovary. So y'all please pray for Linda in this difficult health challenge that she's facing today. Also, I received a request from one of my subscribers that the Clark family from Kentucky, that their 30-year-old son just recently committed suicide. So let's and I believe she said that the Clark family is her pastor at her church there in Kentucky. Our fellow YouTube family member, Lisa Arkle, she's one of my Southern gals. Seven out of nine of her family members have been diagnosed with COVID-19. And unfortunately, her brother-in-law just recently died from the coronavirus. And he was only 57 years old. And he was a Baptist missionary and the postmaster. And this is so sad. His daughter was pregnant at the time of his death, and she was unable to attend her father's funeral. So y'all, that is Lisa Orkel, her family members. Seven out of nine had COVID, and her brother-in-law has passed away from it. And our sweetheart here that we see your comments all the time, Jackie Howard, she had to be readmitted to the hospital on Sunday with congestive heart failure, but the doctor did drain fluid from her body, and she's back home now. And I'm so happy to hear this, Jackie. But y'all, let's please continue to pray for Jackie and for her health problems and her health challenges to do with her heart, that God will heal her heart and make it all brand new again. And let's continue to pray for her husband, Jamie, and his laundry job, who he has, I think he does have a few private clients, but we want to get you some more clients, Jamie, so that you don't have to work at the laundromat. And, you know, whenever the laundromat slows down, then your work slows down. So we'll be thinking about Jamie and his laundry job also. Y'all, he loves doing laundry. And I have a praise report that Bip was able to cross the border from Washington State into Canada, and he and his new wife Izzy are living their newlywed life in Canada in her apartment. Although they are isolated for 2 weeks, but this just gives y'all a chance to bond and to be closer to one another and to get to know each other better. So we have a praise report also. So let me read this song to y'all. My love, when the storms of life come along, you need not fear. I give you courage, reach out and grab it. As a parent consoles their child, I comfort you. There's nothing to be afraid of. Through the eyes of faith, you can do this. Panic and fear are not from me. I wouldn't allow that to be a part of your life. Trusting in the wrong things will bring those feelings upon you. Let negative emotions be a warning sign that you need to put your eyes back on me. Sometimes this is difficult, I know. Life around you. Okay, so my camera clicked off because my phone ran out of storage, but let's just hope and pray that it did store the beginning of the video. So we're going to figure out with this message from Jesus. Sometimes this is difficult, I know. Life around you can alter your perception of me, and then troubles take over. Peter had his eyes on me and was able to walk on the water until he put his eyes on what was going on around him and let fear enter his heart. You must keep your eyes on me to overcome fear. I will personally go before you, and I will not let you down. Trust me. And this is a letter from Jesus, and he signs it, Love Jesus. I love this book. It's so heartwarming. So let's say a prayer now. Please bow your heads with me. Our dear, most gracious Heavenly Father, as we come to you in prayer today, dear God, I just bring forth my friends here who have asked me to pray for them and who have asked our prayer warriors to remember them in prayer. Please just take care of Beth and her family. I pray that you will please just comfort her. Just give her peace. And dear God, please just help her to lean on you to get through this difficult time and this mourning period and this grief of losing her dear mother. And dear most gracious Heavenly Father, I pray for Wanda Landers, that you will please just help her, along with her physicians, to come to the right decision as to how to take care of the breast cancer that she has and the best way to treat it, whether it be with a mastectomy or with treating the tumors. And also I pray for her husband who is suffering with dementia. Dear God, I pray that you will please just take good care of him and just help him, dear God, as he goes through this difficult time in his life, and please just ease the burden on this family. And also pray for Linda, who has a cyst on her ovary, and she's undergoing tests and doctor visits right now to determine if the cyst is cancer. And dear God, I just pray, dear Heavenly Father, please let this cyst on her ovary be benign. Please don't let there be any cancer. In Christ's name, I beg of you. And also I pray for the Clark family of Kentucky, who just recently lost their dear 30-year-old son to the act of suicide. This is so tragic. Such a huge loss, dear God. I just wish, dear God, that you would just help these people. And I know that you will, as long as we ask you to and depend on you to bring these young people through their difficult situations and let them not turn to suicide, Heavenly Father. I also pray for Lisa Arkell and 7 of her 9 family members who have been diagnosed with the COVID-19. And I pray especially for her brother-in-law and his family. I just pray that her brother-in-law will rest in peace now, and that you will please bring comfort and understanding to the family who have lost their loved ones. And I just pray for his daughter who just had her baby and was unable to attend her father's funeral. Dear God, please just give them the strength that they need to get through these difficult times. And I also pray for Jackie Howard, who is suffering with congestive heart failure. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you will please just let the medications and the treatments that she's getting, dear God, will just heal her heart and that she will have a happy and abundant life. And I pray for Jamie that his laundry work will continue to flourish. And dear God, I want to thank you so much for letting Bill be able to cross the border into Canada so that he can reunite with his wife, Izzy. Thank you so much, dear God, for letting this happen and for answering our prayers. And it's all of these things I pray in Jesus Christ's precious name and for his sake. Amen. So I just want to thank you for joining me in prayer today. And I want to wish all of you a wonderful day and a wonderful week ahead. And y'all just keep on coming back. Bye, guys.